Scott, we begin this morning with the latest on a gruesome murder in Manoa. Five people, including a teenager and two keiki, are dead. Our Casey Lund is live this morning from the neighborhood. He's tracking the latest on the investigation and reaction from a stunned community. Casey?
Yeah, Steve, good morning. We just spoke with a neighbor here who didn't want to go on camera. He said it's just really unimaginable what happened early Sunday morning. And while we still wait for the identities of those who were killed here, we do know that police say, at least as far as they are aware this morning, that a man, a father of a family, fatally stabbed his wife, three children, a 17-year-old, a 12-year-old, and a 10-year-old, again, waiting on the identity from the medical examiner's office. But here is what we know from HPD. At a press conference yesterday, they told us they are still investigating a motive here, and they made that horrific discovery yesterday around 9:15. However, we're also told by detectives that the officers first arrived around 8:30 when an anonymous 911 caller called in reporting an argument, asked police to come. They came here, they didn't have cause to enter the home, and they weren't able to contact that 911 caller for that first visit. Then around 9:15, they returned again and made a pretty horrific discovery.
At approximately 9 a.m. today, officers responded to a Manoa home where they found five deceased individuals, an adult male, an adult female, and three juveniles, a 17-year-old, 12-year-old, and a 10-year-old. Their identities will be released by the medical examiner's office. The call was because a witness reported hearing an argument earlier in the morning. Based on the evidence found at the scene and the investigation thus far, it appears that the adult male killed the female and the juveniles with a knife that was recovered from the scene. The motive is still under investigation.
Well, neighbors we spoke to yesterday say that family had lived on the top floor of the home for about 10 years and rented out the bottom portion, adding they would often see families' children playing outside along this quiet street here in Manoa. While the motive, again, as you heard from the lieutenant there, is still unclear, the Domestic Violent Action Center, it says it's important that people recognize the warning signs of abuse.
All too often, we minimize the domestic violence, or we minimize the abuse that may be happening in a family. So as neighbors, we might hear shouting or arguing, and sometimes we just don't do anything about it because it's a private matter. But oftentimes we can reach out on some level to the children or the family members to perhaps get them information that they might need if they or a loved one is going through abuse or domestic violence. The thing I would say is, don't minimize, take it seriously. If you're not sure, just reach out.
Well, if you or someone you know is experiencing abuse, help is available. You can call the National Domestic Violence Hotline, that number 1-800-799-SAFE. You can also text the word START to 88788. Still ahead this morning on Sunrise, we'll hear from Honolulu's Mayor Rick Blangiardi, his response to this tragedy, as well as HPD's Chief Joe Logan, how the department is working to support those first responders that came upon this really horrific, tragic scene yesterday morning. For now, we'll send things back into the studio with Steve.
All right.